माय नेम इज़ कासु नवीन राजू. आई हैव रिटन इंजीनियरिंग सर्विसेज एग्जामिनेशन इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग सब्जेक्ट इन 2017 एंड माय रैंक वाज 70 ऑल इंडिया एंड आई हैव सिक्योर्ड एन इंटरव्यू मार्क्स ऑफ 140 आउट ऑफ 200 एंड माय क्वालिफिकेशन इज आई हैव डन बैचलर्स इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम IIT रुड़की 2015 पास आउट. And then after that, I had an experience of 1 year in Pune in a real estate firm. It's a pure construction firm. So, yes, that's about me. Before the interview, I had approximately 2 months time after the result for interview dates and etc. So, I was pretty sure about the thing that people would concentrate on. The interview would be concentrated mostly on my experience and more on my project, rather than more on my subjects. So I concentrated mostly on my experience mostly. And apart from that, the first thing which I knew about this was it is a personality test, not an interview. So I focused more on my personality and how I communicated, along with the way I showed my gestures, the way I showed my tone, my voice. So these were the major things I concentrated, apart from the way I prepared for subjects. And with regarding to technical, I had a question bank of series of questions from different topics where I need to gain my strength. So I had fears about, I never had fears about my general knowledge or some HR questions because I had experience of many interviews before ESC in various PSUs. So I was very clear about that. But regarding technical, I had somewhat fear regarding that. So I had seen many number of questions from different books available in the market. I prepared mostly objective type of questions because in this interview, mostly they would concentrate on the width of the subject rather than going deep into the subject. So I was pretty sure about preparing more of content rather than going deep into one subject, etc. And apart from technical subjects, there are some questions like general engineering, like if at all you take into civil engineering in structures, there are subjects such as bridges, where they do not ask you about what kind of bridges frame, etc., but they also ask you about where are these kind of bridges, how these bridges take loads, and regarding given a plateau or given a condition on site, what are the kind of bridges you're gonna make. So this was the way I thought I would make my analysis. And so and also in the 2 months which I had, there was mostly I made a group with my friends where I could discuss most number of questions. So subjects like general engineering, where you have to mostly deal with the society in relation with civil engineering, I discussed most of the questions with my friends. I had taken each and everyone's opinion, and we individually made a mock interviews of each and everyone so that we could actually finally come out with a better answer. And regarding mock interviews which I have given in various coaching institutes, I would say I have always taken a video of the mock interview which I have given, and I have analyzed each and every of the gestures which I have made during the interview, and I have improved upon through the interviews which I have given, and I have valuably respected all their feedbacks from the interview panel, and that has actually resulted in very good outcome at the final interview. So regarding interview, so it is held at UPSC Bhavan in New Delhi, and they have a different set of panels for each department, I mean civil or mechanical, etc. So my panel was headed by Mr. Arvind Saxena, and apart from him, there was 3 experts in the subject. As soon as I entered into the room, I had given a warm wishes to them regarding good morning, etc. And then firstly, they were checking out my detailed application form, where they were mainly browsing through my percentages in BTech, percentages in 10th, 12th, and my hobbies and whatever my extracurricular activities, etc. So as I expected in my preparation, they started focusing on my experience. So since my experience was in real estate construction of buildings, they started with plumbing, etc. Plumbing, I would say, what are the vertical stacks, what is vertical stack system in a building, what are the different kinds of stacking systems in a building. And the interview actually starts with the chairman asking a few questions, and I was actually told by many of my peers that answering all questions of chairman would actually result in a better score, so I concentrated more on him. And as expected, I was asked about questions regarding my experience on the vertical stack system. What is the minimum velocity in a sewer pipe? What are the different kinds of material used in a sewer pipe and a water supply pipe? Why an egg-shaped sewer? So these were the questions which were asked by the chairperson. And then there was one subject member. He has asked me about a particular situation relating to my experience only. So he was like, so I have a building in an area like Bhilai steel plant where there has been deposits of ash and the waste from the industry, and it has been deposited approximately for 20 years, so there is a huge pile of all these kind of materials. It's a filled up kind of soil. So now you are, since you have made a 6-story building in Pune in your experience, so can you make the same building here? And if at all you are making the same building, what are the modifications you have to do? What kind of foundation, what kind of structural advantages and disadvantages of both the kind of things, monetary values also, how it's gonna vary, how much. And then regarding the third interview panel, he also concentrated on my experience. Most of the buildings which I worked on, they were platinum rated buildings. It's like IGBC platinum rated buildings. So during the interview, what fetches you more marks is that apart from the way you are showing your technical skills, you also have to add a bit of humor that actually helps. So they asked me a question, right? You are saying that you worked in a building which has been certified platinum rating according to IGBC. And what are the things that are involved in an IGBC rated building? And I was pretty sure that the building I worked on, it was an IGBC platinum pre-certified building. That means before the building has been constructed, there is a rating to the building which is proposed to the municipality of that area, that we are going to construct these kind of things. But after actual prototypes are made on site, they evaluate all the provisions which you have made according to the code of IGBC, and then they actually give you the final rating of platinum rating, silver rating and gold rating. So what I mentioned initially was that my buildings were platinum pre-certified buildings. So I initially told them, as soon as I told them that it is a pre-certified, and I told only a few features which I have actually seen on set, and he was like, but these account only for two or three of a total of 50. So there was a bit of humor from that part. And then the fourth member, she was mostly concentrating on my extracurriculars and my medals which I have won. So I had this medal from Indian Mathematics Olympiad where I secured a medal in my school. So she was like starting with, so you're good in mathematics, so can you just tell me, if I had to run a passenger service, a bus and a metro in Delhi, so how do you calculate the capacity of each, which one is better? So it was a simple mathematics where she also mentioned about the frequency of buses, frequency of metros. So all I had to show was how much capacity of passenger I'm taking in a bus, and given the number of frequency, how many trips in a day, so that would have total out to how many. These were the bit of things. And she also asked me about helmets. Now during construction we use special kind of helmets, and during driving we use different kinds of helmets. So what is the difference between the helmet used on site and helmet used in while riding a bike? How the energy is transferred, which is better, why bike's helmet is better on a bike and why not the normal construction helmet. And after that, it was a peaceful interview, and after that even the chairperson said, you have answered in a good manner, and I was told good and I was asked to leave. That's about my interview. Regarding this interview, firstly, do not think this as an interview. It's just a personality test. They will check the way you are communicating your idea. They will check the way how you are receiving others' question. They also check the way how you behave if at all you lead to an argument. The tone which you are using while communicating, while you are arguing. So, and also be sure with the way you want to say things. Like if at all you want to answer in a question, tell in such a manner that is convincing, and be strong with your technical subjects. And regarding HR, firstly be sure why you are getting into the interview. And I would say that your mains and your pre-score would actually decide whether you're getting a rank or not. But this shuffling of your rank is completely with your interview. I have scored approximately 582 out of 1100 in the mains plus pre. But my score of 114 out of 200 has actually made me shuffle my rank to 70. So be strong, be prepared, and prepare well. That's it. All the best.